In the first episode, we looked at how the ancient Greeks measured the size of the Earth. Now let's look at how they used that size to measure the sun and moon.
Aristotle believed that the moon was a sphere, arguing that the phases of the moon were incompatible with a dish-shaped object. Aristarchus estimated the size of the moon using eclipses. The moon takes about 2 minutes to rise above the horizon. This motion is caused by the Earth's rotation, which takes a day to turn 360 degrees, and 2 minutes to rotate the length of the moon. And that means the moon takes up half a degree of the sky. During a lunar eclipse, the moon falls behind the Earth's shadow for at most 3 hours. It moves through Earth's shadow because it's orbiting the Earth. It takes a month to fully orbit the Earth and 3 hours to orbit through Earth's shadow. So the Earth's shadow occupies 1.5 degrees of the sky. This gives us a moon that is a third the size of the Earth. But this is incorrect because the sun is not a point of light, it's an area of light. This means that the sun casts a soft shadow, which is not one Earth diameter, but 3/4. With this correction, we get a moon that is 1/4 the size of the Earth. We also can find the size of the orbit from the size of the shadow, as 3/4 of an Earth times 360 degrees divided by 1.5 degrees. And that is equal to 2 pi times the distance to the moon, giving us a moon that is 30 Earth diameters away. Aristarchus also did not have a good value for pi, which had to wait until Archimedes a few decades later. Aristarchus realized that during a half moon, the sun, the moon, and the Earth form a perfect right angle. And by measuring the angle theta between the sun and moon, we can calculate the ratio of the distances to the sun and moon as cosine theta. Furthermore, he knew that the sun takes up half a degree of the sky. By measuring the angle theta, we can find the size and distance to the sun, whether it's small and close or large and distant. The problem is, it's very difficult to tell when the moon is exactly half full. See for yourself, is the moon half full now at time A, or B, or C, or D? Each answer gives you a completely different size for the sun. It could be A, infinitely big, B, 109 Earths, C, 5 Earths, or D, 1 Earth. The correct answer is B, but Aristarchus thought it was C. But it was clear to him that the sun is larger than the Earth. He thought it was absurd to have a giant sun orbiting a small Earth. So he had the sun at the center of the universe. But no one believed him. I'll explain why in the next episode. An accurate estimate of the sun's distance was finally worked out by James Gregory and Edmund Halley using transits. A transit occurs when Mercury or Venus crosses in front of the sun. James Cook was sent to observe the 1769 transit in Tahiti. Observers in North America saw Venus cross in front of the sun along a different path, because they saw it from a different viewing angle. By comparing these angles and knowing the distance to Tahiti, scientists determined the sun to be 93 million miles away. Thanks for watching. Next time, we'll cover one of astronomy's greatest triumphs, the Copernican Revolution.